Imagina você conseguir conversar com diversos atores de Hollywood no mesmo dia. Uma das que eu mais gostei, que foi com David Harbour, que faz o Hopper no Stranger Things. E a primeira coisa que eu perguntei pra ele foi sobre como é mudar o tipo de papel que ele faz, já que nesse filme ele faz um cara muito mais comum do que nas outras produções que ele trabalhou nos últimos tempos. Se liga aí como é que foi a resposta dele.
David, we are getting used to see you making badass characters in movies. We saw you in Hellboy, in Stranger Things. We have now Black Widow that's coming. And in this movie, you make a more regular guy, a more normal guy. Does that feel refreshing for you, making another kind of role?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's, you know, it's funny the way you get sort of the, you know, the film business kind of takes you in a certain direction. And I really enjoy this rugged, you know, Hopper character that I get to play, and then to bring that sort of rugged, tough masculinity into something like Red Guardian or Hellboy. But I started out as an actor because I wanted to create things to make people feel less alone, because I always felt such a weirdo that was like had all these impulses and feelings that other people wouldn't talk about and wouldn't share. Then I would go into a movie and I'd see someone represent these weird qualities and I would feel safe. And so I always wanted to do that for other people. And so, you know, I've been doing all these things that are really fun and great. And then it's great to play a guy like this who I feel like is really trapped, imprisoned, of his own making, doesn't have the bravery, has a lot of doors out, but won't walk through them. I think people like that are very beautiful and tragic. And so I'd love to be able to play people like that.
E outra coisa que eu quis perguntar pra ele foi sobre como é que ele se sente sendo um símbolo sexual, já que ele é um cara considerado normal pra muita gente, mas mesmo assim tem um monte de homens e mulheres que ficam loucos quando veem ele em filme. Se liga o que ele respondeu pra mim.
And David, there's another thing that I find very curious, that you became a sort of a sex symbol. And you're like a regular guy that became a sex symbol, and we have that word that's dead body, you know. And how do you cope with that? How do you deal with that?
I mean, it's better than the alternative, I suppose. It's better than being reviled. But it's I mean, I, you know, at its best, I think that if I can do it at its best, most highest level, if I can do anything for people embracing the fact that the unrealistic narcissistic expectations of all of us having visible abdominal muscles, if I can lessen that and you can still be sexy and have an appetite for life and for food and stuff, I think that is a wonderful thing that people see, and I'm glad they can, you know, sexualize me in that way, because I think we need to sexualize and like love people that are real and that have real bodies and real appetites. I'm tired of the traditional, you know, emaciated aesthetic for men and women.
Oh, I thank you very much for that, because I feel so much better than that. And I want to thank you, because every morning when I take a coffee, I remember of you, and it's my mantra for every day.